Hi guys, welcome to Sri Sai Shorthand Coaching Center. 120 words per minute dictation, 7 minutes duration. Get ready. Start. It is my fortune that my pressure of time has permitted me to be amongst you all. I am very proud to say that this institute enjoys a special position among our educational centers. It has intimate connections with the freedom movement. Its graduates have served the nation with devotion all their own and carved out a place for themselves in the people's hearts. This is one of the world's oldest cities, which makes us think what is history and what is civilization. It is regarded as the holiest of the holy cities of the country. It brings to my mind a vision of the dynamic monks of our sacred land. One of them was a weaver by profession, who in this home of brocades taught us that the fabric of India has strands of more than one religion, and that gods are woven into the prayers of our people. It also brings to my mind the very fact that the first college of modern education was founded here. I am reminded of a famous social reformer who had come here to study our ancient scriptures in their purity, but he became convinced that this nation could not live by its traditional knowledge alone. It is this realization which made him the first of the moderns. As I contemplate the history of this place, some more faces come before me, and each of them was in a way complementary to the other. One of them proclaimed that man cannot live by modern knowledge alone, but needed the wisdom that had been discovered and bequeathed by the ancient sages. By a remarkable historical coincidence, the very first gathering of this leading lights of this university heard some plain speaking from the father of the nation, who had just come back from South Asia. His spectacular achievements there had been hailed, but few realized them, that he was to play the same role on the much vaster stage of India. He was still an unknown quantity in India, and so when he spoke of our social responsibility, and especially our duty not to display wealth, it caused much resentment. Some were very uncomfortable, but within a year or two, the country was to find itself dominated by this intruder, who challenged us to look around and identify ourselves with the poorest and the most oppressed, who told us that if only the people of India listened to the still small voice within them, they could simply defy the might of empire. It is out of this awareness of our social responsibility and out of this sense of challenge that this center of learning was born nearly 50 years ago. Its aim was to mold and fashion a new type of Indian. It is appropriate that we should take stock of the social scene of our day and also examine to what extent we have succeeded in molding the new kind of Indian. I had occasion recently to tell a gathering of scientists that there need be no conflict between the Indian man and the modern man, nor indeed the universal man. On this very holy land, thousands of years ago, our sages proclaimed that the world is one family. They thought us that change is the law of life. In our own days, a philosopher who lived and worked in this city advised and admonished us not to be prisoners of the past, but pilgrims of the future. At this place, we heard a new theory of the Indian, a theory which denies Indianness to hundreds of thousands of children of India. Dear sir, we are very thankful to you for your letter of 6th instant, appreciating the services rendered by our engineer in our village. We are also happy to know that the work done as per the advice of our engineer was also recognized by the government. We saw from the local newspapers that such a pattern would be examined and adopted for the needy villages all over the state. We have to congratulate you for our efforts to develop remote villages into modern villages. In your letter, you also expressed that the services of the same engineer may be spared for a couple of months more, and that your project would start in the month of December in other new villages. In this connection, we have to inform you that the said engineer and his team are presently busy in Madras attending a workshop meant for developing very remote villages and hamlets of hill areas. There is no scope at all to provide any amenities in such backward hamlets and villages. There are no roads, no water and power. As such, our team has to do some groundwork there and give proposals for certain schemes which are feasible, keeping in view the interests of the government to uplift the poorest and the weakest. As such, we have to inform you that it will not be possible for us to agree with your request for deputing the said team. Yours sincerely, Consultant.